Welcome to the Bearskin Lounge. I'm Cheryl Smith, the First Lady of Sports Talk, and I am joined by the proprietor live and naked, DizzieMac, and our good buddy, Spitface. We are celebrating the 300th taping of Bras, Panties, and Sports with a discussion from the original crew.
You know, First Lady, I just have to say that. DizzieMac done the thing. I'm sitting up here looking at, how he done put together this naked lounge, and I'm just going, and he got all sorts of bear skin, bro. And you know, really what set it up was he had the peanuts at the door. See, that's what set it up. He had the peanuts at the door. So you know that you can get it going on.
Yeah, DizzieMac, you've been traveling on that bearskin rug, huh? How's it going?
It's going good, First Lady. Hey, you know, just trying to do what I can do. You know, making sure that, hey, we got you in the lounge hanging out.
Yes, my goodness. This is our 300th taping, and it's been how many years now? I mean, going back, what, 3-4 years we've been doing this show? And DizzieMac, you were from one of the original person on the show with me and Spitface. You know, he pops in every once in a while.
Yeah.
But anyway, let's get to some of the stories that we got to talk about. Well, you know, the big story today is that Roger Goodell finally signed his contract, the contract that Jerry Jones didn't want him to sign, but he got it signed anyway. He's going to be making, what, $200 million in 5 years?
Yes.
$200 million in 5 years? I mean, that's kind of crazy, but guess what? The owners were smart this time around. They have decided that his contract, it says that 90% of it is potential compensation and will basically depend on several different financial targets are met. So they're just not going to give him that $200 million. He has to earn it. And as far as I'm concerned, he didn't earn it because there's so much stuff going on in the NFL right now. I mean, we are talking about problems with CTE. You have bad declining ratings. You got the national anthem issue. You got sexual assault problems with the players having several sexual assaults. I mean, has Roger Goodell really done anything good for the NFL this year or the past years? I mean, the only thing he's done, and I guess that's the most important thing, is he still makes money for the owners. I don't know any team that's losing money. Nobody's losing money. So I guess that's the one thing he can't, you know, the owners will care about. But we all know that Jerry Jones, I mean, let's face it, he was upset. And he's still stewing over the Zeke Elliott suspension. But he couldn't stop that contract. So, DizzieMac, this is your lounge. You tell me what you think about Roger Goodell.
Well, hey, Goodell finally got the contract signed. He's been looking, he's been hoping, he's been wishing to try to get that contract in, and he finally got it signed. But, as you said, First Lady, he's got to meet certain criteria. He's got to do what he's got to do, and it always made sure they got the smart element in there, which is, hey, you got to, you know, perform. You got to perform up to what we think you should perform up to. But you got the money. I don't know if you got the health insurance that he wanted, you know, but he got the money, you know. And that's a good thing. And, you know, Goodell has done some good things. He done made sure that the teams are making money. I don't hear nobody complain about not making money and being able to get, you know, being able to eat. Everybody's eating. Everybody's eating good. They may be grumbling, but they're eating. So Goodell did the right thing, and I think, you know, he's going to be, you know, continue to do well as a commissioner, even though he did suspend Zeke.
Okay.
When I'm sitting up and I'm thinking about Roger Goodell, and there are two people. There are two people. And those two people is Vladimir Putin, because we know he's running everything. Oh, Vladdy. So I try to stay on Vladdy's good side because we know he running everything. And then the other one is the Don. And I ain't talking about the Don Trump. I'm talking about Don Roger Goodell. Because those owners, it's some stipulation, all right. The owners knew that they better not mess around with Roger Goodell. That man, he's a bad man. And, you know, when I look at Roger, anybody ever see the movie The Godfather? But especially The Godfather Part 2. Because that, you know, Godfather Part 2 is when Michael just showed his behind, and that is Roger Goodell. Roger Goodell say, look, owners, I'm going to tell you how much you're going to pay me. And I'm going to tell you the terms that you're going to put on me. And the owner say, yep. And when the owner get out of line and say, well, Roger, you know, I don't know if we like what you say?
What?
Hey, you over there bumbling and mumbling, you know, being like Freddie. You know how Freddie was. I'm smart. And Roger Goodell just give you that look, you know, you're owner. I'm Goodell, you know. And I tell you, other than Vladdy, because Vladdy a bad boy. That Vladdy is a bad boy. Whew, man. And, you know, get your popcorn ready. That's all I can say on that subject. But Roger Goodell is the man in sports, and he done made his point. And did he get that free jet for life? That's all I want to know.
Okay. Well, you know, Roger Goodell, he got some more problems going on because, like you said, there's been some problems throughout the NFL, but this season, and particularly that Monday night football game between the Steelers and the Bengals, there was a lot of heavy hitting there. Two players were really hit hard, and actually one of the players, I mean, he really wasn't hit hard from the hit, but it was he had a terrible situation with his back injury. But Bertha, I think is his name, he got knocked down from Choo Choo. What's his name? I can't remember his name.
Juju Smith-Schuster.
Juju, right. What kind of name is that? Well, I don't know how his parents woke up and decided they were going to name their child Juju. But anyway, regardless of the fact.
They wanted to make sure he didn't go to prison. If they knew with a name like Juju, he had two choices. Either go to the military or play football.
Play football. Well, he decided.
But you know what? Name like Juju. You ain't going in nobody's prison with your name Juju. So he got it together. That was how that rolled.
That's how that rolled. But anyway, so there seems to be a lot of discussion regarding is football getting too tough? I mean, are the hits getting too hard? You know, the NFL now is considering doing the targeting rule similar to the college football. Can you believe they're going to bring that in the NFL, the targeting rule, because of these hits? You know, they're going to make an example like they do the college game, and the players will be ejected. So, DizzieMac, what do you think about that? I mean, I know you played football, and you probably played in a time when it was really hard-hitting type of football.
Yeah, he go back when they had those leather helmets. Only thing is, because he was black, they couldn't get leather. So he had to use silk scarves.
Yeah.
But see, they had that you know, that fried, dyed, and lay it like it live stuff, so it made a cushion.
So DizzieMac, what's your take on this?
Hey, first lady, I think football has been rougher even before this. There was a time where, hey, it was just, hey, hit'll be knocked out. You know, you had to hit. You had to come up with the big hit. It was physical. Hey, we just not taking no prisoners. Pittsburgh Cincinnati. I mean, that's divisional game. I can't expect nothing less than people getting hit. You cracking back. If your job is to crack back, you crack back. And Juju Smith-Schuster cracked back on Burfict. You know, he may have looked at him and just seen his eyes roll back in his head, but, you know, that's just the nature of the beast. That's why you got teammates. Keep them off of them. But, football is going to be physical. They're getting bigger. They're running faster. They're hitting harder. They going at it tougher. I mean, what can you do? Put a dress on them? No, I don't think so. But let them hit. I think it's just that. I think maybe the hits like Gronkowski. You know, why would you just hit the man on the ground? I mean, you clean that up. But, hey, most of the time it's just going to be physical hitting. I mean, you know what it is when you sign up to play. You come in there, not tippy-toeing, going full speed because you know what could happen. But I don't have no problem with the way football is being played. I mean, lighten up. They playing a sport. They playing a sport that they love. They like to hit. You know, that's what the fans want. They want to see the hit. They want to see the physical contact. They call it for it. You know, let it be. I'm cool with it. I'm cool with the first lady. I don't have no problems with it.
You have no problems with the way they're playing. What do you think, Spitface?
When I look at it, I think that the intensity and the level of the hitting is not has been highly overreported. And I think what it is because of the fact that, you know, we got 50, 60, 79, 100 different angles. We can slow mo it, speed it up, show all the sweat popping off the guy's face so that it just adds to the drama of what actually happened. So I don't think these guys hitting any harder than they was hitting last year, 10 years ago. If anything, I think that they are in a better situation today because of uniform designs and, the improvements in the helmets. So I don't think that the hitting has gotten any tougher than before. Because I put it like this. You sit up here and you rambling down the field and Ray Lewis, lay some wood on your butt. You know, 10 years ago, we would have said, man, did you see the hit he put up? Come on, what's my man out of the Giants? the Hall of Fame Giant defensive player. They got a couple of them, but I'm thinking with my man with the Tifus. But now when he hit your butt, and they said, look, he was the only defensive player who could change a game, So, it's been some great hitters, and it's been some great hits, but it ain't like that's all the time. Come on. It's just too much drama and stuff, And if it was, Don Goodell would take care of it.
Don Goodell. Well, he's trying to take care of it. That's why he's trying to implement this policy that they have in college. But I kind of agree with you that the game has changed over several seasons now to protect the players more so than before, because now you can't hit helmet to helmet. I think there's a crackback or whatever the different types of hits they have. But I mean, one of the Pittsburgh Steelers players, he was complaining that they continue to water down the league. It's going to be like playing like flag football. So I mean, I kind of agree with him. I mean, the hits are not like they were back in the day, like Jack Tatum and all those type of way they used to hit. I mean, they used to hit hard. So I think it has changed. They're protecting the players more. And, to me, they don't need to make any more changes. Leave the football the way it is. And, I hate that college rule because, you know, when they go back and the player hits somebody, I mean, they don't do it intentionally. Sometimes it just is the nature of the game, and that's just what happened. I mean, you know when things are done intentionally. Like what Gronkowski did, that was intentionally. I mean, he did a WWE move on the football player. So, and the fact that he only received one game, I mean, obviously there's another situation going on with that because he should have at least gotten two games for what he did because he did that with intent. Juju, whatever, Smith, his situation was different. It was within the game. So sometimes you can't control yourself. His problem was that he stepped over the guy, and you know that's what made his situation look worse than what it really actually was because he stepped over the guy. Because if we're not remember, he did that to Burfitt. You know what type of person he is. He's always hitting people illegally. So as Antonio Brown said, it was karma. Yeah, he deserved it, I guess, is what they were trying to say. So I don't think there needs to be any more changes with the game. I think the game is fine. I'm glad that they allowed the celebration back. I think it's fun watching them do all the different celebrations. I just thought that
was I hate the celebrations. I hate the celebrations. I'm like, oh, man, good. This ain't no high school, college. That come on. Bring a little class to the game.
Oh, no, I love the celebration. I mean, it's fun. That's what you got to put the fans back into. It is real fun. So, DizzieMac, any final words you would like to say? And we do appreciate you joining us on our 300th taping of Bras, Panties, and Sports. Any final words for you?
First lady, I'm just honored to be part of the 300th show. I mean, we go back, you know, like four flat times. We go all the way back. You know, I remember, you know, first meeting you. You know, you still the first lady. I can't say you changed an inch or anything. You still in there doing what you do. Hey, I still, you know, enjoy being on the show with you. So, man, I tell you, me and the Bearskin Rug and Shimmy Shake Girls, I'm telling you, we just broad panties for life.
Okay. All right. Spitface, any final words?
I just want to say that, it is amazing what can happen when like-minded peoples gets together. It's a good thing.
It's a good thing.
It's a good thing.
Well, DizzieMac, I know, you know, it's been really great hanging out with you. We miss you, and I know you hanging out with you in the lounge, and we'll always have a hot mic waiting for you with the ladies of Bras, Panties, and Sports. We look forward to seeing you again.
Hey, what's up now?
Brother, what's up?
This is a big party, man.
Yeah,
I can dig it.
Stop right off.
What's up?
Mother, mother, there's too many of you to cry. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you die. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah. Father, father, we don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate.
You know we've got to find a way
to bring some loving here today. Picket lines and picket signs, don't punish me with brutality. Talk to me so you can see,
sister.
Oh, what's going on?
What's going on?
What's going on?
What's going on?
Yeah, what's going on?
What's going on?
Oh, what's going on?
What's going on?
Oh, right now.
What's
going on?
Hey, man, what's your name?
way to judge us simply cause our hair is long. Don't punish me with brutality. Come on, talk to me so you can see what's going on.